Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Kohan Shama, te hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Kohan Shama, te hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Page 219. Let the soul of everything alive bless your name, Adonai, our God, and the spirit of all flesh glorify and exalt your name forever, O Sovereign. Transcending space and time, you alone are God. We have no sovereign besides you, God of the first and God of the last, God of all creatures, master of all generations, who is praised in a multitude of praises, who guides the world with abundant loving kindness and all creatures with mercy. Adonai neither slumbers nor sleeps. God awakens the sleeping, arouses those who slumber, gives speech to the mute, and God loosens the bond of the captive. God supports the fallen and strengthens those who are bent over. You alone do we acknowledge. We continue together over the page. Even if our mouths were full of song as a sea, and our tongues full of joy in countless waves, and our lips full of praise as wide as the sky's expanse, and were our eyes to shine like sun and moon, if our hands were spread out like heaven's eagles, and our feet swift like young deer, we could never thank you adequately, Adonai, our God and God of your ancestors, to bless your name for a 10,000 on the many myriads of times you granted favors to our ancestors and to us. Therefore, these limbs which you have formed in us, and this spirit and soul that you have breathed into our nostrils, this tongue which you have set in our mouths, they must acknowledge, bless, praise, and glorify your name, O our Sovereign. For every mouth will acknowledge you, and every tongue pledge homage to you. Every knee bend in your presence, every upright person shall bow before you. Every heart will revere you, and every inmost thought will sing to your name. And David said, let all my bones exclaim, who is like you, Adonai? As David continued, bless Adonai, O my soul, and let my inner being praise your holy name. We continue now with the Chatzi Kaddish, page 224.
Yikadal v'yikadash shemei rabba.
Amen.
Be'al ma'adiv rachu te v'am lich malchu te. Be'cha yechon uv'yom echon uv'chayde kol be'Yisrael. Ba'gala, ba'gala uv'izman kariv v'imaru. Amen. Yehe Shemei Rabba Mevarach Le'alam Ulamei Amaya Yitbarach Yitbarach V'yishtabach V'yipa'ar V'yiromam V'yitnaseh V'yitadar V'yitaleh V'yitalel Shemei D'kudashah B'richu Le'elamin Kol Birchata V'shirata
Tushbechata V'nechemata Da'amin ram be'alma v'imaru amen.
Please rise for the call to worship, page 226.
Lai, 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 lai. Lai, 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 lai. Lai, 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 lai. Baruch Hu et Adonai HaMevorach. Baruch Adonai.
joined together on page 228 with Yotzer Or. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, Yotzer Or uvorei choshech, Osei shalom uvorei et hakol, Hameir laaretz v'ladarim aleha barachamim, Uvtuvo michadesh b'chol yom tamid ma'aseh v'reishit. Ma'arabu ma'asecha Adonai, kulam b'chokhma asita, mala ha'aretz kinyanecha. Tit barach Adonai Eloheinu, al shevach ma'aseh yadecha, va'al me'orei or sha'asita yifa'arucha selah. Or chadash al tzion ta'ir, V'nizkeh chulanu mehera la'oro. Baruch atah Adonai, yotzer hama'orot. Baruch atah Adonai, yotzer hama'orot. Page 230. How deeply you have loved us, Adonai, our God, gracing us with surpassing compassion. On account of our forebears, whose trust led you to teach them the laws of life, be gracious to us, teaching us as well. O merciful one, have mercy on us by making us able to understand and discern, to heed, learn, and teach, and, lovingly, to observe, perform, and fulfill all that is in your Torah. Enlighten our eyes with your Torah. Focus our minds on your mitzvot. Unite our hearts in love and reverence for your name. Then we will never feel shame, never deserve rebuke, and never stumble. Having trusted in your great and awesome holiness, we shall celebrate your salvation with joy. We continue together. Gather us in peace from the four corners of the earth, and lead us upright to our land. For you, O God, work wonders. You chose us, truly.
You drew us near to your great name,
that we might acknowledge you, declaring you one in love. Praise be you, Adonai, who chooses your people Israel in love. Baruch atah Adonai, habocher ba'amo Yisrael ba'ahava.
Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Elohecha. Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Elohecha.
We now continue together with Fea Hafta on page 234.
Fea Hafta, et Adonai Elohecha, b'chol levavecha u'v'chol nafshecha u'v'chol me'odecha v'hayu ha'devarim ha'ele. Asher anochi mitzavecha hayom alevavecha vishinantam levanecha vidibarta bam beshivtecha bevetecha uvlechtecha vaderech uvshochbecha uvkumecha ukshartam leot ayadecha V'hayu letotafot b'neinecha uchtavtam al mezuzot b'techa uvisharecha. Leman tizkeru
Va'asitem et kol mitzvotai, v'item kedoshim le'lohechem. Ani Adonai Elohechem, asher hotzeiti etchem, me'eretz Mitzrayim, liyot lachem le'lohim. Ani Adonai Elohechem. At this time, I would like to invite Carol Boyd Leon to the Bima. She has been a very special and important teacher and friend since I was little. She will share her own musical interpretation of the prayer we just chanted.
You shall love your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might. Set these words which I command you this day upon your heart, upon your heart. Teach them faithfully to your children. Speak of them in your home. On your way and when you lie down, and when you rise up, bind them as a sign upon your hand. Let them be symbols before your eyes. Inscribe them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates and on your gates. Teach them faithfully to your children. Speak of them in your home. On your way and when you lie down, of all my mitzvot and do them. So shall you consecrate yourselves to your God. I am your God who led you from Egypt to be your God. I am your eternal God.
Adonai Eloheichem, Emet. Page 238. For us, this eternal teaching is true and enduring, beloved and precious, awesome, good, and beautiful. The God of the universe is truly our sovereign, the rock of Jacob, our protecting shield. God endures through all generations. God's name persists. God's throne is firm. God's sovereignty and faithfulness last forever. God's words live and endure, faithful and precious for eternity. Together. From Egypt you redeemed us, freeing us from bondage. For that, your beloved sang praise, exalting you. Your dear ones offer hymns, songs, praise, blessing, and thanksgiving to you as sovereign, the living and enduring God. High and exalted, great and awesome, God ever humbles the proud, raises the lowly, frees the imprisoned, redeems the afflicted, helps the oppressed, answering our people when we cry out. Praise to God Most High, blessed is God and deserving of blessing. In great joy, Moses, Miriam, and Israel responded with song to you, all of them proclaiming.
Mecha mocha, ba'eli madonai. Mecha mocha, ne'dar ba'kodesh, no ra te'hi.
rise for tefillah, which begins on page 242. Adonai sifatayv tivtach ufi agit tehilatecha. Adonai, open up my lips, that my mouth may declare your praise. Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu, ve'lohe avoteinu ve'imoteinu, Elohe Abraham, Elohe Yitzchak, ve'lohe Yaakov, Elohe Sarah, Elohe Rivka, Elohe Rachel, ve'lohe Leah, ha'el ha'gadol ha'gibor ve'hanora, el elyon, Gomel chasadim tovim, v'kone hakol, v'zoher chaste avovim ahot, u'mevi gula livnei v'neihem, lema'an shemo be'ahava, melech ozer u'moshia u'magen. Baruch atah Adonai, magen Avraham, v'ezrat Sarah. Ata gibor le'olam Adonai, mechaye hakol, ata rav lehoshia, morid hatam. Mechalkel chayim bechesed, mechaye hakol berachamim rabbi. Somech noflim verofe cholim, umatir asurim. Umekayem en munato li shenei afar Michamocha ba'al givurot umido melech Melech meimit umekaye umatchmiya yeshua V'ne'eman ata lechayot hakol Baruch ata Adonai mechaye
Page 248.
Kadosh, 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 Adonai Tzevaot, Melech kol ha'aretz, kivodo.
Adir, adirenu, Adonai, Adonenu, ma'adir, shimcha b'chol ha'aretz.
Baruch kivod Adonai, mikomo.
To all all generations, we will declare your greatness, and for all eternity, proclaim your holiness. Your praise, O God, shall never depart from our lips. Blessed are you, Adonai, the Holy God. Please be seated. Responsibly, top of page 253. We offer thanks, O God, for this Shabbat, which unites us in faith and hope. For Shabbat holiness, which inspires sacred living. For Shabbat memories, glowing even in darkness. For Shabbat peace, born of friendship and love. We offer thanks and blessing, O God. Baruch atah Adonai, mekadesh ha-shabbat. We continue responsively in the middle of page 255. On this holy Shabbat, may we draw near to life, to peace, and to joy. May we find true rest, holiness in our deeds, worth in our study of Torah. Let us feed on the love of goodness. Let us drink from the love of goodness. Restrain our thirst for excess and cleanse our hearts to serve life well. On this holy Shabbat, may we draw near in life, in peace, and in joy. Baruch atah Adonai, she'odecha levadecha b'yira na'avod. On page 257, please respond, Modim anachnu lach, which means we thank you. For the expanding grandeur of creation, worlds known and unknown, galaxies beyond galaxies, filling us with awe and challenging our imaginations. Modim anach nulach. For this fragile planet Earth, its times and tides, its sunsets and seasons. Modim anach nulach. For the joy of human life, its wonders and surprises, its hopes and achievements. Modim anach nulach. For human community, our common past and future hope, our oneness transcending all separation, our capacity to work for peace and justice in the midst of hostility and oppression. Modim anach nulach. For high hopes and noble causes, for faith without fanaticism, for understanding of views not shared. Modim anach nulach. For all who have labored and suffered for a fairer world, who have lived so that others might live in dignity and freedom. Modim anach nulach. For human liberties and sacred rights, for opportunities to change and grow, to affirm and choose. Modim anach nulach. We pray that we may live not by our fears, but by our hopes, not by our words, but by our deeds. Blessed are you, Adonai, your name is goodness, and you are worthy of thanksgiving. Baruch Atarunai, Hatov Shimcha Lecha Na'ele Odot.
Tova uvracha, chen v'chesed v'rachamim v'rachamim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'al kol Yisrael, amecha. Barcheinu yotzreinu kulanu ke'echad be'or panecha. Ki be'or panecha natata lanu Adonai Eloheinu.
Sin shalom, tova uvracha, chen v'chesed v'rachamim v'rachamim aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'al kol Yisrael, amecha.
Torat chayim v'havat chesed, utzdaka uvracha, v'rachamim v'chayim v'shalom. Sim shalom,
sim shalom, tova uvracha, chen v'chesed v'rachamim v'rachamim aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'al kol Yisrael, amecha.
V'tor b'enecha livarech et amcha Yisrael, v'chol et u'v'chol sha'a b'shlomecha. Sim shalom,
sim shalom, tova uvracha, chen v'chesed v'rachamim v'rachamim aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'al kol Yisrael, amecha.
Baruch Osei ha-shalom.
Baruch Atarunai, Hamavarech Atomo Yisrael ba-shalom.
Amen.
We pray silently.
Shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael ve'imru amen.
Amen.
Our Seder Kriyat HaTorah this morning begins on page 362. I'd like to invite up to the pulpit to take part in the Torah passing ceremony Caroline's grandmother Ruth and her parents, Bill and Sally, and also to open the ark for us, Marjorie and Donald Schaefer and Fred Davis. Please all join us up on the pulpit.
Ein kamocha ba Elohim Adonai ve'ein kema'asecha malchutcha malchut kol olamim u'memshaltcha bechol dor v'ador. Adonai melech, Adonai malach, Adonai imloch leolam va'et, Adonai os le'amo yitein, Adonai yivarech et amo v'shalom. Av harachamim hektiva birtzoncha et zion, tivnei chomot Yerushalayim, tivnei chomot Yerushalayim, ki becha levad batachnu melech Aram v'nisa Adon Olamim. Ki Mitzion tetze Torah, ki Mitzion tetze Torah, udvar Adonai Mirushalayim, Baruch Shenatan Torah, Torah, Baruch Shenatan Torah, Torah, Le'amo Yisrael, B'kdushato. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Echad Eloheinu, Gadol Adoneinu, Kadosh. God Lularunai iti unaromama shemo yachtav.
I'll turn the page turner here too.
Caroline, first I want to tell you that I'll be doing all the speaking parts today for both your parents. It's not that your mother doesn't want to speak. It's just that she is, as the rabbi would put it, part of the Bethel Crying Mothers Club, of which I see we have a few of the other members here today and some honorary members as well. So it falls on me to speak on both your parents' behalf. Passing down the Torah from generation to generation is one of my favorite parts of the tradition of the bat mitzvah service, and a tradition we didn't have, or I recall, growing up at my temple. Actually, the first time I remember seeing the passing of the Torah down was here at Beth El about 2 years before you were born. And while the father was speaking, as I am now, my mind wandered. To what I might say to the child going through the ceremony. So I should warn you, I've been working on this for about 15 years now. I want to start by telling you how proud of you we are today. It's not that we aren't proud of you every day. but it's not every day we get to tell you in front of all our family and friends.
We are very proud of you.
We are very proud of you for not just reaching your bat mitzvah day, but in how you have done so. You have worked harder and practiced more to prepare for today than you have for anything else you have ever achieved. But you don't realize you started working on this day many days, many years before when you started learning Hebrew and the various prayers. And hopefully you will continue with your Jewish education the rest of your life. Beyond just learning to read Hebrew, you reached this day in great fashion. While many of your classmates and other young adults complained about having to attend religious school, you never did. Instead, you enjoyed coming to religious school. You embraced it. You made a whole new set of friends. You learned Hebrew about Judaism, our history and holidays. You sang in the choir. You performed in Purim spiels. And you learned how to help others in your community. Also, your teachers, many of whom are here today, have always told us that you don't just participate in class, but you are a leader who tries to help their best to help everyone. You can always be counted on to raise up the whole group or just an individual when needed, at which point we usually look at the teacher in question and ask, are you sure you're talking about the same Caroline? But really, these are skills that you have exhibited will take you far in life, so keep up that great attitude as you continue your Jewish and regular education. Now back to handing down the Torah from generation to generation. While it may seem that we're just handing down a scroll with lots of stories and lacking of vowels, it's this part of the ceremony is really much more. Handing down the Torah symbolizes passing down many years of both your mother and my family's history, culture, traditions, as well as this great learning tool. By accepting and reading from the Torah, you are becoming an official part of our adult family and all that comes with it. Hopefully someday you can pass all this down to your children. Along with all the family history and traditions, you are also accepting the most read book of all time. And I know you love to read a good book. The Torah has been read, interpreted, and discussed for thousands of years. So you can read it over and over and always learn something from each week's portion, as you will show us in your Dvar Torah today, by letting us know what this part of the Torah means to you. Also, what a particular portion of the Torah means to you today will change in a few years, which is why it is such a great read and learning tool, and you will always find new meaning every time you read it. I know I've gone on longer here than you wish, but I have just a few more thoughts. Earlier I talked about how proud we are of you for reaching this day. And remember how hard you have worked to reach your bat mitzvah, but it is really just a beginning. It is a stop along a long journey. You will soon be part of the Jewish community here at Bethel, but that doesn't mean you stop working at all the things that got you here. As you are proving today, you can accomplish just about anything you really want with hard work and lots of practice. Beyond that, remember, it isn't just the end result that counts, but how you get there. Many of the traits you have shown in helping those that may need a little extra assistance or helping those in the community that are less fortunate will serve you well as you continue your education and throughout your life. One of the biggest tenets we try to practice here at Bethel is tikkun olam, which means you have to do your part in helping make this world a better place. Up until now, you have shown a great sense of this, and we hope that whatever you do moving forward, you continue to practice this, and you will accomplish a great deal. And I think you'll find you enjoy getting there much more, which is often what really counts, how you get there. Finally, as I hand you the Torah, always remember, while you are always willing to help those around you, those same people will always be there to help you as well. Your friends, your teachers, your family, your grandparents, aunts, uncles, cousins, even your sister. Especially your mother and I, we always want the best for you. And remember that we always love you and truly are proud of you every day, whatever you accomplish.
Dear Mom, Dad, Nani, Poppy, Grandy, Grandma, Grandpa Ed, and Grandma Sue. Exactly 3 years ago, on August 25th, I found out that I would be reading from the Torah for the very first time. 3 years seemed like a very long time to everyone, but now look where we are. I'm becoming a Jewish adult and becoming a member of the Bethel Minyan. I was anticipating this event when I was 10, but now I am positively eager to follow through with this significant family tradition. Not only am I eager, but I am also proud that I am able to stand before you now because of those who sacrificed their lives in order to keep our faith thriving. Now, by accepting the Torah, I will be able to read all of the stories in the language in which it was written and meant to be spoken. This will mark the day I get to read the Holy Scroll, which will bring me one step closer to God. Today, I am also filled with hope for the world and myself. This emotion reminds me of Anne Frank, who suffered and yet kept her faith that a better day for the Jewish people would eventually come. Her ideal of a world of kindness and love could have been seen as foolish at the time. In fact, she wrote in her world-famous diary that, "It's really a wonder that I haven't dropped all my ideals because they seem so absurd and impossible to carry out. And I keep them, because in spite of everything, I still believe that people are really good at heart. Just like Anne Frank, I have the same ideals. Not too long ago, I would not have been permitted to hold, read from, or pass the Torah. Not only because I am a girl, but also because those who sought to do away with the Jewish practices, that sought to do away with the Jewish people, began their attacks by slowly banning Jewish practices. There are positive similarities between Anne Frank and me, but one important difference. The ideals we share are more manageable for me today than they were for her 67 years ago. In 67 years, many things have changed in the world. It's a wonder to think that more than 50 years ago, my grandpa had his bar mitzvah, then my dad had his, and now I stand here, the next link, the next generation, having my bat mitzvah. I believe that one day my child will become another link to another generations of Jews as he or she fastens the chain of tradition. As I was being prepared for this day, I was able to better understand how we became who we are as Jews. I also had a better understanding of how important it is to continue to pass along these customs. In my research for this speech, I came across a passage from Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 9, that I believe expresses the important idea of passing along your heritage. It sums up what Anne Frank has given to me and what I can pass down to future generations of Jewish people. Do not forget the things your eyes have seen or let them slip from your heart as long as you live. Teach them to your children and your children's children. By accepting the Torah today, I'm dedicating myself to the words of God. I'm promising myself, my family, this congregation, and God that I will not forget or disregard this holy scripture. By accepting the Torah today, I'm joyously taking on all the responsibilities that come with handling and reading this precious scroll. I look forward to the Saturday when I will stand before you and read the Torah once more. I want to thank the people who helped form who I am today and who will continue to help shape my character in the future. With everything that my parents, my family, my friends, and this caring congregation have given me, I realize that my character is formed not only by my hands, but by your hands as well. Anne Frank wrote, "The final forming of a person's character lies in their own hands. Thank you again for keeping your hand in mine."
Lecha Adonai ha-gedula, ha-gevura, ve-ha-tiveret, ve-ha-netzach, ve-ha-od. Kichol ba-shamayim u-va-aretz, kichol ba-shamayim u-va-aretz. Lecha Adonai ha-mamlacha, ba-mit-na-seh, lechol rosh. Romemu Adonai Eloheinu v'hishtachanu l'harkotshav. Romemu Adonai Eloheinu v'hishtachanu l'harkotshav. Ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu. Romemu, romemu. Ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu, romemu, romemu, romemu Adonai Eloheinu, v'hishtachanu l'harkotshav. Romemu
Adonai Eloheinu v'hishtachavu lepar kodesho. Ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu romemu, romemu. Ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu romemu, romemu. Romemu Adonai Eloheinu v'hishtachavu lepar kodesho. Adonai Eloheinu v'hishtachavu lepar kodesho. Al shlosha devarim, al shlosha devarim ha'olam ha'meid, al shlosha devarim ha'olam ha'meid. Al ha'Torah ve'ha'avoda ve'al gemirut chasadim. Al ha'Torah ve'al ha'avoda ve'al gemirut chasadim. Al shlosha devarim, al shlosha devarim ha'olam ha'meid. Al shlosha devarim, al shlosha devarim ha'olam omed. Al shlosha devarim.
I'd like to invite Sarah and Kalila Hamid forward to help us undress the Torah.
Lo yisa goy el goy cherev, lo yilmedu gvod milchama. Lo yisa goy el goy cherev, lo yilmedu od milchama. Lo yisa goy el goy cherev, lo yilmedu od milchama. Lo yisa goy el goy cherev, lo yilmedu od milchama. Lo yisa goy el goy cherev, lo yilmedu od milchama. Lo yisa goy el goy cherev, lo yilmedu.
Please be seated. All right, you come stand there.
My Torah portion is entitled Shoftim, Deuteronomy, chapter 18, verses 9 through 22. This portion informs us of Moses as he instructs the Israelites not to use magic and teaches them how to distinguish a true prophet from a false one. I wonder, why aren't the Israelites allowed to use magic? And if you don't use magic, what will the end result be? You may follow along in your Torah commentary, a large book which you may have picked up on your way into the sanctuary, beginning on page
1298. Good, okay, find your place there. Edward Schneider and Jody and Tammy Schneider.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach,
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Leolam Va'ed,
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Leolam Va'ed, Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Hamin, V'natan Lanu Et Torato, Baruch Ata Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen. Amen. Ki Ata Ba el haaretz, asher Adonai Elohecha notein lach, lo tilmad lasot, ketoavot hagoyim haheim, lo yimatze vecha, mavir bano uvito baish, kosem kisamim, meonem umnachesh umchashef. Vichover chaver, vishoelov, vide oni, vidoresh el hametim. Kito avat adonai, kolose ela, uviglal, hato avat ela, adonai elohecha, morisho tam mipanecha. Tamim tihe, im adonai elohecha. Ki hagoyim ha'ele asher ata yoresh otam el monenem v'kosamim yishma'u ve'ata lochein natan lecha Adonai Elohecha. When you enter the land that the Eternal your God is giving you, you shall not learn to imitate the abhorrent practices of those nations. Let no one be found among you who consigns a son or daughter to the fire, or who is an augur, a soothsayer, a diviner, a sorcerer, one who casts spells, or one who consults ghosts or familiar spirits, or one who inquires of the dead. For anyone who does such things is abhorrent to the Eternal, and it is because of these abhorrent things that the Eternal your God is dispossessing them before you. You must be wholehearted with the Eternal your God. Those nations that you are about to dispossess do indeed resort to soothsayers and augurs to you. However, the Eternal your God has not assigned the like.
Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher natan lanu Torah emet, v'chaye olam nata v'tocheinu. Baruch ata Adonai, noten ha-Torah.
Amen.
Ya'amdu la Torah Rachel bat Yaakov u'baruch ben David. Rachel and Tom Levy.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvarach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam, Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Hamim, V'natan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Atah Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen. Amen. Navi Mikir Becha Me'achecha Kamoni Yakim Lecha Adonai Elohecha Elav Tishma'un Kechol Asher She'alta Me'im Adonai Elohecha Bechol Rev Bayom HaKahal Le'mor Lo Osef Lishma Et Kol Adonai Elohai Betaish Hagedolah Hazot Lo Ereot Velo Amut Vayomer Adonai Eli Heitivu Asher Diberu Navi Akim Lahem Mikeravachehem Kamocha Vinatati Divarai Bifiv Vidiber Alehem Eit Kol Asher Atzavenu. Yet kol asher atzavenu v'haya ha'ish asher lo yishma el divarai asher yidaber v'shem. Anochi Ed Rosh Me'imo. From among your own people, the eternal your God will raise up for you a prophet like myself, whom you shall heed. This is just what you asked of the eternal your God at Horeb on the day of the assembly, saying, let me not hear the voice of the eternal my God any longer, or see this wondrous fire any more, lest I die. Whereupon the eternal one said to me, they have done well in speaking thus. I will raise up for them from among their own people a prophet like yourself, in whose mouth I will put my words, and who will speak to them all that I command. And anybody who fails to heed the words the prophet speaks in my name, I myself will call to account.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu Torat emet v'chayei olam nata b'tocheinu. Baruch atah Adonai notein haTorah.
Amen.
Ta'amod la Torah, kochava panina bat baruch haba bat mitzvah.
Baruch hu ad Adonai hamvorach.
Baruch Adonai hamvorach le'olam va'ed.
Baruch Adonai hamvorach le'olam va'ed. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher bachar banu mikol hamim. V'natan lanu et Torato, Baruch atah Adonai, notein haTorah.
Amen.
Ach HaNavi, Asher Yazid, Lidaber Devar Bishmi, Et Asher Lotziviv, Lidaber V'Asher Yidaber, B'shem Elohim Acherim, Umet Hanavi Hahu, V'chi Tomar B'Yovavecha, Echa Neda Et Hadavar, Asher Lo Dibero Adonai, Asher Yidaber Hanavi, B'shem Adonai, V'lo Yiheyeh Hadavar, V'lo Yavo, Hu Hadavar, Asher Lo Dibero Adonai, V'zadon Dibero Hanavi, Lo Tagur Mimenu. But any prophet who presumes to speak in my name, an oracle that I did not command to be uttered, or who speaks in the name of other gods, that prophet shall die. And should you ask yourselves, how can we know that the oracle was not spoken by the Eternal? If the prophet speaks in the name of the Eternal, and the oracle does not come true, that oracle was not spoken by the Eternal. The prophet has uttered it presumptuously. Do not stand in dread of that person. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu Torah emet v'chayei olam nata b'tocheinu. Baruch atah Adonai notein haTorah.
Amen.
We just heard the words of Torah. We now take a moment to think of our family and our friends, those who are in need of healing, and join together in a Misha Berach prayer on their behalf. Invite Charlie and Ben Bullman to please join me up on the pulpit to address the Torah. Will the rest of the congregation please rise?
V'zot haTorah asher samoshe lifnei bnei Yisrael al pi Adonai v'yad Moshe.
Comes from the book of Isaiah, chapter 51, verses 17 through 23. The Haftarot comes from the writings of the prophets. They were originally read at a time in history when the Israelites were not permitted to read the Torah in public, but today are concluding readings emphasizing the lessons from the Torah. You may follow along in your Torah commentary, beginning at the bottom of page 1316. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher bachar binvim tovim veratzah v'divrehem hane'emarim be'emet. Baruch atah Adonai habocher batorah uv'moshe avdo Uv Yisrael amo, uvin v'yei ha'emet v'atzedek. Hitoreri, hitoreri, kumi Yerushalayim asher shatit. Miyad Adonai et kos chamato et kubat. Kos hatarela shati matzi ein minahela mikol banim yalada ve'ein machazik beyada mikol banim gidela shetayim heina korel tayich miyanud lach Hashod v'hashever v'hara'ah v'chacherev mi'anachamech banayich olefu shachfu b'rosh kol chutzot ketol michmar hamle'im chamat Adonai karaat Elohayich lachen
Shemina azot aniyah Ushchurat velo miayin Koamar Adonaiich Adonai Velohaiich yariv amo Hine lakachti Miadech et kos hatarela Et kubat kos chamati Lotosifi lishota od Batasi Visamti habiyad melgaich Asher amaru linafshech shechi V'na'avora Batasi micha aretz gevech V'chachutz la'overim Rouse yourselves, rise up Jerusalem. You have drunk from the Eternal's hand the cup of wrath and drained to the dregs the bowl that made you stagger. She has none to guide her. Of all her children she bore, none to take to her by the hand. Of all the children she raised, these two things have befallen you. Devastation, destruction, who will console you? Famine and sword, who can comfort you? On every street corner, your children will lie senseless, like antelopes in a net, glutted with the wrath of the Eternal, your God's rebuke. Therefore, listen to this, you who are afflicted, drunk, but not with wine. Thus says the Eternal One, your Sovereign, your God, who defends you. I am taking from your hand the cup of staggering. No more shall you drink from the bowl of my wrath. I will put it into the hands of your tormentors, those who said, lie down for us to trample you, so that you made your backs like the ground, like a street for passers-by. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech ha'olam, tzor kol ha'olamim, tzadik b'chol hadorot, ha'el ha'ne'eman, ha'omer v'oseh, ha'mdaber kayem, shekol divarav, emet v'tzedek, al ha'torah, v'al ha'avodah, v'al ha'nevi'im, v'al yom ha'shabbat hazeh, shenatat alanu, Adonai Eloheinu, likdushav limnucha, lechavod ultifaret, al hakol, Adonai Eloheinu, anachnu modim lach, umarvachim otach, yitbarach shimcha, b'fi kol chai, tamid leolam vaed, baruch atah Adonai, mekadesh ha-shabbat.
The portion that I read today informs us of the instructions that Moses relays to the Israelites from God. Moses directs the Israelites not to use magic like the other people who used to reside in the Promised Land. He stresses how much God detests their practices of human sacrifice and methods of discovering the future that usually turn out to be inaccurate. Moses also informs the people of Israel that God will raise up a prophet like Moses, and he or she will speak God's words truthfully and accurately. Moses then tells the people of Israel how to distinguish a real prophet from a false one. After studying this scripture, the first question to pop into my head was, why can't the Israelites use magic? Harry Potter does, and it seems to work just fine for him, most of the time. But this was not a fantasy. The people who God was driving out of the Promised Land were trying to discover the future before it was necessary, and they used methods that included harming others. Magic seems like it would be the easy way out, but when I think about it, Magic is actually a much more complex process because it requires going through more effort in order to discover information that in the end will probably be a fabrication. God wants the Israelites to trust in God's decisions and wants to be able to trust that they will exercise good judgment by abandoning sorcery and fortune telling. After reading this portion of scripture, it is obvious to me that I'm not magical and no one is. Just like the Israelites, I'm left to my own judgment that comes from listening to God. I will also be able to make my own decisions using what I have learned from my parents, my rabbi, my cantor, family, and the Torah. Of course, I want to know what the future holds. Doesn't everyone? But we don't need to know the future right now. God has good intentions when forming my future. Because of this, I have a sense of trust that everything will turn out fine no matter what. I do not take the easy way to find the future. I allow the future to follow through as it was meant to. Piecing together all that I've learned from Deuteronomy chapter 18, in the end, it all comes down to trust. I trust that God is making good decisions for me and for the rest of the world. One of the best decisions God ever made for me was placing me in a family that loves and cares for me. Because of this affectionate gesture from God, I have no need to seek out tarot card readers or psychics. The present is what really counts. The present can affect the future. Doing well in the present will produce a better and brighter future for me. I hope that some of my thoughts inspire you to trust God more than ever and to live in the moment. Thank you for listening.
Don't go anywhere. Wait.
Caroline, you certainly led us through the whole service this morning. You can breathe now, by the way. And I have no doubt brought a lot of blessing to your family, to your friends, to those who are here this morning as you took your place within our community. And now to return some of those blessings to you, I'd like to invite your parents to please come back and join us up on the pulpit.
Dear God, thank you for bringing us to this day. Almost 13 years ago, Caroline was born, and it was one of the happiest days of our lives. Today is another big milestone. There have been many in between, birthdays, graduations, performances, concerts, holidays, and other events to celebrate in between. While these occasions are great landmark events and reason to celebrate and give thanks, I think the moments we have found most enjoyable are those little moments that come along the way. I think back to earlier this year when Caroline was learning her Torah portion and kept getting stuck on a particular word. After about 2 days of working on the same part and much frustration with everyone involved, she finally got it right. She knew it, and boy, did it show.
You sure you don't want Mommy to read it?
We can't forget play practice and listening to Caroline and Kate in the back seat of the car discussing their costumes for a show or how they needed to practice particular lines for a scene. Finally, there's the pure joy we get from listening to how excited Caroline is anticipating upcoming events, both big and small. As Caroline continues to grow and learn, there will be many more milestones and accomplishments. Our hope and dream is that she works as hard for these to reach those moments and to do her best as she did today. Don't let Caroline forget to enjoy herself, her friends, and her family along the way. Please remind Caroline that oftentimes it is the little things that will bring her the most joy and that she will always remember. Lastly, help us to be the best parents we can be. May the God of our people, the sovereign of the universe, bless you. May the one who has always been our guide inspire you to bring honor to your family and to our people, Israel. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, shehechiyanu, v'kiyamanu, v'higiyanu, lazman hazeh. We give thanks to you, O God, our eternal our God, sovereign of the universe, for giving us life, for sustaining us, and for enabling us to reach this day of joy. Amen.
I could have. I offered.
She's still going to be fine.
In a moment, Cantor Steinberg and I will be taking Caroline and her parents over to the Ark to offer up our own blessing. And as we do so, I ask that each of you will offer up a blessing for them within your own hearts as well. May God bless you and keep you. May God's countenance shine upon you and may God be gracious to you. May the light of God's love shine very, very brightly in your life and give you peace all the days of your life. And let us say, Amen.
Caroline now joins Bethel Hebrew Congregation as one in our minyan. This is an extremely proud moment for this congregation. What a blessing she is. What a blessing we know she will continue to be. And so one of her teachers, Mr. Mike and I, would like to offer a blessing on to mark this moment. Take these wings to fly with.
Shmi Biti, with these roots you will grow. This is my promise. This is my blessing.
You are the promise.
And you are the blessing. Shma Bini.
Shma Bini.
Shmi Biti.
Shmi Biti.
Shabbat.
As we prepare to offer up return the Torah to the Ark, we offer up a blessing for our country and the State of Israel, and I'd like to invite Kate Schneider to please come forward and do that for us.
O guardian of life and liberty, may our nation always merit your protection. Teach us to give thanks for what we have by sharing it with those who are in need. Keep our eyes open to the wonders of creation and alert to the care of the earth. May we never be lazy in the work of peace. May we honor those who have died in defense of our ideals. Grant our leaders wisdom and forbearance. May they govern with justice and compassion. Help us all to appreciate one another and to respect the many ways that we may serve you. May our homes be safe from affliction and strife, and our country be sound in body and spirit. Amen. O Heavenly One, protector and redeemer of Israel, bless the state of Israel, which marks the dawning of hope for all who seek peace. Shield it beneath the wings of your love, spread it over the canopy of your peace. Send your light and truth to all who lead and advise, guiding them with your good counsel. Establish peace in the land and fullness of joy for all who dwell there. Amen.
Amen.
Please turn now back into your prayer books to page 374. And I'd like to invite Sue Pemberton and Farouk Hamid forward to open the ark for us. For the rest of the congregation, please rise. Hallelujah, Shem Adonai, ki nisgav shemo, levado.
Shamayim vayarem keren le'amo tehilah lecho chasidav livnei Yisrael am kerovo. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Kilek aktov natati lachem, torati al tazo.
Etz chayim hi, lamachazikim ba, v'tomecheha meushar, d'racheha d'archei noam, v'chon tivoteha shalom. Hashiveinu Adonai Elecha Benashuva Chadesh, Chadesh Ameinu Chadesh Ameinu Kekedem.
The Aleinu begins at the bottom of page 586.
Aleinu l'shabeach la'adon hako la'teit gedula li'yotzer breshit she'lo asanu k'mevei ha'arz matzot ve'lo samanu k'mishpachot ha'adama she'lo sam chelkenu kahem ve'gor aleinu k'cho ha'monam va'anachnu kore'im Umishtachavim umodim lifnei melech machei hamlachim hakadosh baruch hu shehunote shamayim veyosed aretz umoshav yikaro bashamayim mima'al ushchinatuso bekov hei meromim Hu Eloheinu Einod Emet Malkeinu Efesulato Kakatu v'yadata hayom, v'yadata hayom, v'hashevota elevavecha, ki Adonai hu ha'elohim, b'shamayim mima'al, v'aretz, v'aretz, mitachat ein od. V'ne'emar v'haya Adonai l'melech al kol ha'aretz b'yom ha'hu, b'yom ha'hu yihye Adonai echad u'shema, u'shema, u'shema echad.
Please be seated.
Our thoughts turn to those who have departed this earth, our own loved ones, those whom our friends and neighbors have lost, the martyrs of our people whose graves are unmarked, and those of every race and nation whose lives have been a blessing to humanity. As we remember them, we meditate on the meaning of love and loss, of life and death, as we remember Ezra John Schrenzel, Howard Ochakoff, Joni Feingold, Robert Steinberg, Paul Gustav Clemens, Morton Clone, and Jay Wertheimer, and those whose Yahrzeits occurred this time, Max Albert, Seymour Berman, Rena Braun, Sidney Cardozo, Abraham Cohen, Ethel Damlin, Theodore Fenyo, James Fleisch, Bruce Jeffrey Folak, Ruth Franklin, Fanny Frommer, Morris Goldberg, Harry Goldman, Jack Gropman, Gerald Grossner, Victor Hertz, Selig Horowitz, Ethel Horowitz, Edna Caffey, Jerome Kaufman, Eleanor Koslow, Jonathan Allen Laster, Mildred Leff, Hyman Podolsky, Max Pretzfelder, Herbert Reebok, Jacob Rose, David Rosen, Bernard Sinberg, Gertrude Weinberger, Eugene Weinstein, Samuel Wendell, Helen Wolf, and to those we add Sunny Davis, Joe Litwack, Kate Dreyer, Agnes Comer, Troy Comer, Jane Davis, Robert Davis, and David Schneider. Are there any other Yahrzeits anyone would like to remember this morning? If so, please call out the names. May the memories of all of them be remembered for blessing. As together now as a congregation we rise and join in our Kaddish prayer, page 598. Yit gadol v'yit gadash shemei rabah, v'yolma divrach yirutei v'yamlich malchutei, v'chai echon v'yom echon v'chai yedachol beit Yisrael, v'agala v'izman kariv imru amen, yahei shemei rabah mevarach l'olam v'olmei omaya. Yit barach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ah v'yitromam v'yitnaseh v'yitadah v'yitaleh v'yitalal shmei d'kudsha b'richu le'ela min kol b'yorchata v'shirata tushbechata v'nechemata d'amiran b'yoma v'imru amen Yehei shlama rabba min shmaya v'chayim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen Oseh shalom b'mromav hu yaseh shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael. Amen. May the source of peace send peace to all who mourn, comfort all who are bereaved, and let us say, Amen. Please be seated.
We now conclude the formal part of our worship this morning with the singing of Ein Kelohenu, page 626. Ein Kelohenu, Ein Kadonehenu, Ein Kimokenu, Ein Kamoshienu, Michaelohenu, Michadonenu,
Michem Alkeinu, Mich Moshienu, Nodel Eloheinu, Nodel Adoneinu, Nodel Alkeinu, Nodel Moshienu, Baruch Eloheinu, Baruch Adoneinu, Baruch Malkeinu, Baruch Moshienu, Atahu Eloheinu, Atahu Adoneinu, Atahu Malkeinu, Atahu Moshienu.
Caroline, can I have you back up here, please? Caroline, it occurred to me that your house must be a very interesting place during Hallmark commercials and watching Bambi.
Nope.
We have a few gifts for you. First of all, on behalf of our Women of Reformed Judaism and our Brotherhood, I'd like to invite Art Gershman forward to present you with your Kiddush cup.
Well, Carolyn, we've watched you grow up in this congregation from Tat Shabbat all up to where you are now, and many Shabbat dinners, family dinners, and you did a wonderful job today. You had a clear, confident voice, and I was convinced that you were speaking words of truth. So on behalf of WRJ and Brotherhood, I'd like to present you with this Kiddush cup, and I hope you'll use it for many Shabbat dinners.
Thank you.
Now, on behalf of our whole congregation, I'd like to invite one of the vice presidents of our congregation, Julianne Bemisco, to present Caroline with her certificate.
Caroline, on behalf of the Bethel leadership, I want to welcome you into our congregation. I know that having followed the model of your parents, who are such wonderful role models, that you will become involved with our synagogue and do tikkun olam and the world at large. I was very moved by your speaking today and by the Torah portion, and I think it was wonderful to remind us that even God wants us to be mindful. Who in this congregation who's sitting here right now doesn't have worry about the future or possibly regret about the past? But the best time management advice I ever got that I'd like to share with you as a teenager, because I know how much stress you have, is that if you're spending your time worrying about the future and the past and you're not spending time being mindful of today, you're wasting a lot of time. So you get a whole bunch more time if you spend it thinking about the here and now. So I hope that as you grow, you will remember always your Torah portion. And just in case you don't, we do have this lovely certificate for you in case you wake up tomorrow and go, did that really happen? It really did, and I hope you'll remember us fondly when you review it. We also have a few certificates for you. There's a guest membership for the JCC for a year and some certificates for travel to Israel. And just want to wish you and your family mazel tov and thank you.
Now I'd like to invite all of Caroline's friends, her cousins, Kate, to please come and join us up on the bima. Come, guys, don't be shy.
Shabbat Shalom.
Where's Diego? Yeah.